Hello, welcome. This video is on the basis and dimension of vector spaces. Initially, I'm going to do the introduction to Euclidean space, then basis and dimension. Finally, dimensions of the four subspaces. Let's get started. Consider R squared, the Euclidean vector space represented by a plane. It is seen like a two-dimensional space with I and j being the unit vectors or the standard orthonormal basis. The properties are: any vector v of R squared can be written in terms of I and j, meaning that I and j is a spanning set of R. 2. The vectors I and j are not collinear, meaning that the set ij is linearly independent. 3. The vectors I and j are orthogonal, and each of them has norm as 1. 4. The set ij has two vectors or elements. Property 1 and 2 makes it a basis. Property 3 makes it orthonormal, and property 4 makes it a two-dimensional space. Generally, the vector space R to the n of all n tuples of real numbers has basis E1, E2 till En, where E1, E2 are En as shown. And this can be generalized to vectors of matrices, functions in any arbitrary dimension. Let V be a vector space, then the set S, which is equals to V1, V2 up to Vn, which is a subspace of V, is a basis if S is linearly independent and spans V, and the dimension is equal to the number of elements found in S. Example: show that S equals to x squared, x, and 1 is a basis for P2, the set of polynomials of degree 2. We need to first show that span S is equals to V. So let P be an element of P2, then P equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. Then there exist scalars ci such that P is equal to the sum of ci times si. That implies, hence, span S is equal to V. Secondly, is S a linearly independent set? The zero vector of P2 is 0 is equal to 0x squared plus 0x plus 0, and the sum ci si is equal to 0. That implies c1x squared plus c2x plus c3 is equal to 0x squared plus 0x plus 0. That implies c1, c2, and c3 equals to 0. Then the 0 combination is the only solution, so S is linearly independent, and that implies that since span S equals to V and S is linearly independent, that implies that S is a basis and the dimension of S is 3, since S has only 3 elements. If S equals to V1, V2 up to Vn is a basis of the vector space V, then for any V in the vector space V, V can be represented in terms of V1, V2 up to Vn in exactly one way. Bases are not unique. Two bases have the same size and dimension. If W is a subspace of V, then the dimension of W is less than or equal to the dimension of V. Let S be the basis of the vector space V. Then the vectors in S can be used as a column matrix of a matrix A that carries all the properties of the set S. Recall, rank is a number of pivots. Through matrix A of order m times n, one defines four fundamental subspaces whose dimensions are revealed by the rank of A. 1. The column space with dimension equals to rank A. 2. The row space with dimension equals to rank of A transpose. 3. The null space with dimension equals to n minus r. for the left null space with dimension equals m minus r. It consists of all possible vectors Ax representing the linear combination of the columns of A. Ax equals b is solvable if b is in the column space, that is, describes all the obtainable right sides. So the dimension of the column space of A equals to the number of pivots, which is equal to the number of non-zero rows in the reduced row epsilon matrix of A, and is equal to rank A, which is equal to R. Example, consider the set S V1, V2, which is a subspace of R cube, where V1 is equal to 142 and V2 equals to 033. Let A be the 3x2 matrix with the columns which are the vectors S. The column space of A fills up a plane R cube. It is a plane spanned by the vectors V1 and V2. 2. Describe the column space of I. The column space of I is R squared, since every vector in R squared is a combination of the column space of I. Go. It consists of all possible solutions of x of the equation Ax equals to 0, including x equals to 0, where x is in R to the n. The dimension of the null space is equal to the number of free columns of A, which is equal to the number of zero rows in the reduced row epsilon form of A, which is equal to n minus r. Example, consider the system Ax equals to 0 with A given above. Find a basis and hence find the nullity of A. Note, the nullity of A is also equal to the dimension of the null space. Since Ax equals to 0, that implies x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x4 plus 4x5 equals to 0, and x3 plus 5x4 plus 6x5 equals to 0. Since we have 5 unknowns and 2 equations, we fix the values of x2, x4, and x5, and we obtain x1 equals to negative 2a minus negative 3b minus 4c, and x3 equals to negative 5b minus 6c. Hence, we have x as follows. Then, expressing x in linear combination form, we have the following matrix, and let v1, v2, and v3 be the elements of the set S. This implies that span S equals to null A, and x is equal to 0 when A, B, and C are equal to 0. That implies that the nullity of A is equal to 3, which is also equal to the number of columns minus the rank A. It consists of all possible solutions x of the equation A transpose times x equals to 0, including 0. The dimension of the left null space of A is equal to the number of free columns of A transpose, which is equal to the number of zero rows in the reduced row epsilon form of A transpose, which is equal to m minus rank A. The row space consists of all possible vectors A transpose times x, representing the linear combination of the rows of A. This implies the row space of A fills up R cube. It is a space spanned by R1, R2, and R3.